Hello, I'm Mike with this week's new and trending AI tools you cannot afford to miss.
Coming up, we'll look at Meta Llama 4 and see if we can actually use its 10 million token context window. We'll have a quick play with the Google Firebase Studio, a competitor to Cursor, V0, Lovable, and more. And finally, I got invited to Manus, and I'll be testing out Manus AI to see if it can build me an app without me touching a single key on my keyboard.
Meta released Llama 4.
Thank you, Mike, in America. This is Mike here in the UK. It's been a busy week. Llama 4 runs on a single GPU. It's got a massive context window. Llama 4 Scout supports 10 million tokens, making it ideal for analyzing code bases. So let's get in and test it out. You'll see here it's live on day zero on Grok Cloud, and you'll see I'm in the playground, and here there's a bunch of different models, but of course I've got Llama 4 Scout 17B with a mixture of experts. Yes, 16 different experts available to me, so I can't wait to try this out. To give it a test, I've gone to the Model Context Protocol Servers GitHub, because that's very in right now. I tried to make my own MCP server a few weeks ago. Now, I've used a website called Uthub, which is the same as GitHub, but you just change the G for the U, and you get a flat file of everything that's in the Model Context Protocol Servers GitHub. That's pretty cool, right? And you'll see up here, I've got just over 250,000 tokens. So nowhere near the 10 million limit, but this will be good for a test. So with all this code analyzed, yes, there's a lot of it there. I'll just click copy, which is up here. And as the message here, I'll say, tell me step by step how to make an MCP server, colon, and then command V. This is the whole code base that I'm now submitting to Meta's Llama 4. Let's submit and see how long it takes to come up with the answer. Okay, sadly here on Grok, I've hit a token limit. Yes, I requested quite a few tokens and they only allow 6,000 tokens per minute. Let's instead go to the official Meta AI site. Which model are you? I'm Meta AI, built on, yes, you've seen it here, Llama 4. Let's click go and see if it will process all of those tokens at once. Yes, there's... Oh, your prompt is too long. I'm having trouble testing out a high amount of tokens. Now, this is nowhere near the limit. So where do you go when you've got a lot of tokens to process? Let's try Hugging Face over here, Meta Llama 4 Scout 17B. And again, there's that prompt. Tell me step by step how to make an MCP server. Let's paste in. Okay, something has happened here, but there is no response. There's no response. If anyone knows a place where I can use a high amount of tokens with Meta's Llama 4, please let me know in the comments down below. Next up, you have to see Firebase Studio from Google. It's kind of like Cursor, V0, Lovable, Replit, all of your favorite AI coding tools all in one. Google really is coming in as the giant here. Let's take a look at how exactly it works. Okay, so here we are at the welcome screen. This is all new, and all you have to do is accept the terms and also opt into any updates you may want. Let's click confirm, and here it is. Hello, Mike. What do you want to build? You can prototype apps with AI, and of course, it gives you some options here. It also gives you some frameworks to work with. This looks pretty comprehensive, so let's give it a go. And another cool thing this week is that XAI introduced Grok 3, available via their API, Grok 3 and Grok 3 Mini, with some pretty reasonable input and output pricing here. So very, very useful and available. You've got fast versions where you can pay a little bit more. You can also access Grok 2 Vision and image generation. So all of those are available, including all the legacy models as well. So I thought I'd use Grok 3 in an app that I'll build with Google's Firebase Studio. Let's click here into example usage for Grok 3 Mini. That's the cheaper one. And I'm going to copy and paste all of this page over into Firebase Studio, where I'll say, make an app that tracks real-time sentiment on Tesla using the Grok 3 Mini API. Example here, and this is the example usage that I've copied. Let's prototype with AI. And we can see straight away that Firebase Studio is getting to work thinking about this. Now, it's thinking through all the features that it needs to build. I really like the way this is working. It's also working on the color styles and layout, typography, animations. Now, the cool thing is I can go in and customize anything that's been created here. I can change the colors as well if I wish, but I'm just going to go ahead and prototype the app. I've got to say it's blazing fast. I can't wait to see what it comes up with. Wow, this is very cool indeed. Now we can see as it's wrapping up here, it's actually checking for errors before it hands off to me again. And it's actually auto fixing an error right here. Let's check out the code. And yes, it's asking for my XAI API key, which is great. So we'll paste that in there. And now it's loading up. Okay, it's pulled some stuff in here. And it's got some news. It's got Twitter stuff here. It's all a little bit janky and clunky, but it's definitely pulling from the XAI API. So I'm just saying over here, make it dark mode, format Markdown correctly, and make the graph smaller and not collide with the text, and we'll let Firebase Studio fix this. And we can see now the text is formatted correctly, but that graph is still colliding with the text. It's not great. So while Firebase Studio is in its early days, it definitely shows promise, although I think it's going to need a bit more prompting to get something that's usable. Now, that's not the only thing that got an update this week. If I copy one of my latest YouTube video links and paste it into Google's AI Studio, you'll notice now that Gemini pulls in the YouTube video and I'm able to perform some analysis. Give me a short overview on this video. Now we can click to open those model thoughts, and it's actually timestamping everything that's happened in the YouTube video. And finally here, it summarizes the video is about lead capture, automation triggers, email lists, AI research, AI email writing, and email sending. This is excellent stuff. And not only can we do this in Google's AI Studio, but we can also use the API. So essentially that means you can analyze any YouTube video using Google's very own API. Every tool I speak about in this video is linked up down below, and remember to like and subscribe if you're enjoying what you see. Okay, finally this week, after everyone else, it seems I got the invite to try Manus. Okay, I'm in, and it seems I have 1,000 free credits available to use. Let's test this out. Okay then, let's see if I can get one decent app built on this video. So build me an app that finds recent trending videos for any search query type by the user. It uses Gemini 2.5 Pro Preview to think and reason why the videos did well and suggest ideas for the user based on top videos from the query. Okay, we can see it's thinking things through. It's executing commands to start to make stuff. And if I open this up down here, we can actually see what's going on with the task progress. So it's got all of these to-dos on its to-do list and it's working through step by step. I can note up here, I can enable browser notifications if, of course, I want to be notified when this is done because it may take some time. Now I can see it's already made a Python virtual environment and is installing that. Now already cleverly enough, it's using the YouTube data API here to search for trending videos. Okay, Manus has been working for quite some time and it's still going. I've successfully implemented the YouTube data API and it's continuing to make my app for me. And you can see here, it's working on integration with the Gemini API, all here under the hood without me touching anything. There is Manus's computer, which I can click here and open if I want to see what it's doing. It's looking at exactly how it should be doing this implementation. Really clever stuff. Okay, what is really cool here is it's actually come to a pause and it's given me instructions for getting my YouTube data API key and also my Gemini API key that will be needed for this app to work. Now, before I go ahead and use this at the temporary URL it's deployed to, I'm going to go ahead and open VS Code. And now I'm going to go into the Trending Videos app, go to the .env, and I need to place in my API keys. Okay, it's all up and running. It's actually given me a public link here to test the app out. So let's go ahead and test it out with the query like Manus AI. Okay, we can see the trending videos, but unfortunately, as hard as I try, no Gemini analysis and content ideas. That might be an error with my API key. I did try swapping it out a few times, but at least we've got a basic app built using Manus, and the amazing combination of tools there is just incredible. The fact that it uses Code Server to handle all your code in a VS Code style environment, it works in the terminal seamlessly and fixes errors, and it also uses browser use to actually do online activities on the internet, doing things such as researching APIs and how to actually put the app together. Really impressive stuff, and I suggest you try it. Use the link down below to access Manus today. And let me know your thoughts in the comments. And YouTube is showing a video on your screen right now that you should watch next.